We turn now, though, to the backlash against a new painkiller. Zohydro hit the market just last month, and already Massachusetts has banned the prescribing and the dispensing of this drug.
Meanwhile, Vermont has issued an emergency order that would make it harder for doctors to prescribe this drug. So let's bring in Dr. Jennifer Ashton with more on this. Good morning,
Good
Dr.
Morning,
Ashton.
You guys.
And so we talked about this drug when it came out last month. What's so different about it, and why is it so easy to abuse?
You know, Bianna, first you have to remember the premise of medicine is to do no harm. And when you're talking about a drug like this, I'm not sure that the benefits outweigh the risk. This is an incredible pure, powerful opioid narcotic. It does not contain acetaminophen. It stays in the body and the bloodstream longer than other traditional painkillers, and it is igniting a firestorm of controversy within the medical community and the public alike.
But the FDA did approve it, so there must be some benefits, right?
Yeah, Dan, you know, the benefits, this is another big tool in the arsenal against chronic pain, which affects 1 in 3 Americans. This is not for short-term use. This is for use more than 3 months. The big thing with this drug, Zohydro, is that it doesn't contain acetaminophen, and that is important because we've heard a lot about the fact that acetaminophen overdose accidentally when taken with opioid narcotics is the leading cause of acute liver failure in this country. So that potentially is a huge benefit.
And we should mention that the maker of the drug says that they're going to set up a board of experts to review. What can we expect them to do? And as you, I was interested in what you told me off camera, that this is really an American problem.
Absolutely. I mean, we use more than 99% of the world's opioid narcotics here in this country. The risks with this, which are the risks of all of this class of medication, it has a very high potential for abuse, a very high potential for misuse and accidental overdose and addiction. So they are going to be looking at this very, very carefully. The big opponents to this drug have a problem with the fact that it doesn't contain any abuse deterrent. So therefore, it can be crushed, it can be inhaled, it can be injected. That is the last thing we need with this class of medication because misuse is already a massive problem.
Well, thank you for bringing this to our attention.
Proceed with caution.
And work with your doctors on it.
Absolutely.
All right, Jen. Thank you.
You bet.
Thanks, Jen.